Hello friends, welcome you all. From today onwards, we are going to start a mission mode approach for UPSC prelims 2021. It is scheduled to be held in the month of June, but from today onwards, we are going to work on the most important aspect of remembering important factual data from your general studies paper, and that is brain teaser. So we'll be having this complete series of brain teaser for all these subjects. Today we are going to start with first topic, which is art and culture in history. Today we'll try to understand the first important aspect of Indus Valley civilization. One important objective of this series, in this series I am not going to give you conceptual clarity. This series will plainly be focused towards giving you more and more information base, and secondly, this series is aimed at giving you more data which you can also use in your mains examination after you once you complete the prelims exam. So let's start with first. Today we are going to study about Indus Valley civilization. This is the diagram of Indus Valley civilization. It is located around this Indus Valley. You can go through this diagram, you will realize it is Indus Valley, which has its tributaries like Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bias and Satluj. We'll go for it. We'll go for every point one by one. Here I will be explaining few important points that you have to keep in mind. First thing, Indus Valley civilization was the first major civilization in South Asia. I am not saying in the world. Try to remember key points which I am hitting. It is the first major civilization in South Asia. It has been spread across the vast areas of India and Pakistan, present India and Pakistan, having 12 lakh square kilometers of the area. The time period for maturing of Indus Valley civilization is estimated between 2700 BC to 1900 BC. It is almost spanning for 800 years, but also it is said that early Indus Valley civilization had existed before even 2700 before Christ also. So if possible, try to remember time period which you can write in UPSC mains. UPSC prelims generally do not ask you time questions on time frame. Then what are the features of Indus Valley civilization? Try to remember every single point that I am explaining over here. You can close your eyes, you can just listen what I am saying. First, the first feature of Indus Valley civilization, it was located on the valley of river Indus. First point, it is also known as Harappan civilization. The most important aspect, Indus Valley civilization is also known as Harappan Valley civilization. It is the beginning of city life in South Asia. This is important character. The city was divided into two parts. One was citadel, that was west. It is the that larger area of the town which has more traders and all other people. Second was lower town, which was located in the east. Remember, citadel were located on west and lower towns were located on the east. Red pottery was there, which was painted with designs in black. They could reverse the point. They could say you that black potteries were there designed in red, but it is not the case. Red potteries were there which were designed in the black. Then what all aspects were there? Stone weights were there, that is weights and measures that you use, like kilogram, volume, whatever measures that you use were present in Harappan civilization also. Stone weights were there along with various seals, mohar. Special beads were there, special beads like small monies were there. Then copper tools were there. Remember, copper was there, an important element. Long stone blades were also present. Copper, bronze, silver and gold were present. Just star mark this point. Copper, gold, silver and bronze were present. Artificially product were there like faience. What is faience? Faience were a glazed pottery having all kinds of design, and this glazed pottery was more in demand. Remember, faience is a glazed pottery. Then what are other features? First, Harappan civilization was specialized in handicrafts. Second, it imported important raw material. It means Harappan civilization had contact with the outside world. Plow was used. Remember this point. In Harappan civilization, plow was used. Bodies were buried in wooden coffin. Coffin, that box used to put dead bodies. Coffins. So bodies were buried in wooden coffins. But during latter stages of H symmetry culture. So it remember, in Harappan civilization, Indus Valley civilization, H symmetry culture was there. In H symmetry culture evolved where bodies were buried in painted burial urns. Urns means you must have seen those mummies. wooden coffins are different aspect. Urns where a very larger box is there made of Chinese clay or all other kinds of clays, and on that urn a coverage will be there having portrayal of queen, king or demon. So urns were used. Sugarcane was not cultivated. This question was being asked. Sugarcane was not cultivated and horse and iron was not used. Remember, sugarcane, horse and iron was not present. Then these are some of the important sites, Indus Valley sites, and what are the specialization of all these sites. You could get the question first. First important site is Harappa. This information is also important for UPSC student who are appearing or who are having history as their optional subject. First site was Harappa. This Harappa site was excavated by Dayaram Sahani in 1921. Now this Harappa site is situated on the bank of river Ravi in Montgomery district of current Punjab province in the Pakistan. What are the important findings in the Harappa? Sandstone statue of human anatomy. Granaries were there where you could store grains. Bullock carts were there. Then second important site was Mohenjo-daro, on which you have a movie from Hrithik Roshan. The meaning of Mohenjo-daro is mound of dead. It has been excavated by R.D. Banerjee in 1922. It is situated on the bank of river Indus in Larkana district of Punjab, province of current Pakistan. Larkana district. First was in Montgomery. It is in Larkana district of Punjab, province of Pakistan. It is second aspect. Then third, what were the discoveries? It had great bath. Then it had granary. Bronze dancing girl was there. Seal of Pashupati Mahadeva. Then there was titite statue of beard man. And a piece of woven cotton was also found in the Mohenjo-daro. Then third one is Sutkegendor. It is stained in, it was excavated by Stain in 1929. It is in southwestern Balochistan province of Pakistan. On which river? On Dast river. Remember, Sutka Gendar is important site. It is located on Dast river in south Balochistan. It is a trade point between Harappa and Babylon civilization. Remember, Sutka Gendar is a trade point between Harappa and Babylon civilization. The next important site is Chanhudaro. It is excavated by N.G. Muzumdar in 1931. It is Sindh on Indus River. It is located on Sindh province in Indus River. Bead maker's shop was found. Bead means those money that are used in a necklace, beads. Then footprint of a dog chasing cat has been found. Star mark this point. It is important. Footprints of a dog chasing a cat has been found. Then next important site is Amri. It is again excavated by N.G. Muzumdar in 1935. It is again on the bank of Indus River. Antelope evidence has been found. Star mark this point. Antelope evidence has been found. Then important site is Kalibangan. Many of you might have heard about this with your seniors who are preparing for civil services, UPSC mains. Kalibangan, it is excavated by Ghosh in 1953. It is located on Rajasthan on the bank of Ghaggar River. It has found fire altar, camel bones and wooden plow has been found. The next important site is Lothal. It is excavated by R. Rao in 1953. It is in the state of Gujarat, current India, on Bhogwa River near Gulf of Cambay. Bhogwa River. Remember name of the river? Bhogwa River, Gulf of Cambay. First man-made port, it is Bhogwa. Then it has dockyard, it has rice husk, fire altars and chess playing was found. Remember, first man-made port has been found on the Bhogwa River near Gulf of Cambay. Next important site is Surkotada. It is excavated by J.P. Joshi in 1964 in the state of Gujarat. It has bones of horses and beads were found. Then next important site is Banavali. It is excavated by R.S. Bisht in 1974. It is in Hisar district of Haryana, Gujarat, Haryana. It has found beads, barley and there was evidence of both pre-Harappan and Harappan culture was found. So you could get a question on which site pre-Harappan and Harappan sites have been found. It is in Banavali in Haryana. The next one is Dholvira. It is again excavated by R.S. Bisht in 1985. It is in the state of Gujarat in Ran of Kutch. It has, here they discovered water harnessing system or water harvesting system and water reservoirs were found. Then let's think about the religion of Harappan people. See, the Harappan people or Indus Valley civilization people, they worshipped Pashupati Mahadeva. Pashupati Mahadeva is also known as Proto Shiva. Mother goddess was worshipped by them. They were nature and animal worshipper. Unicorn, dove, dove means kabutar. People tree and fire was also worshipped by them. Amulets were there. Amulets, the tithe that you use on your arm band. So, then armpit. Idol worship was practiced. Star mark this point. Idol worship was practiced in Harappan civilization, which is not a feature of Aryans. Then they did not construct a temple. So by reading all above things, you might feel that Harappan civilization is synonymous with Hinduism. No, here remember the similarity to Hindu religion was found. Similarity to Hindu religion practices were found. Hinduism in its present form originated many years after Harappan civilization. Caste system was absent. Remember, in Harappan civilization, caste system was absent. Then what about the society and culture of Indus Valley? The systematic method of weights and measures were found. And the weights and measures were in the form of 16 and its multiple. Weights and measures were in the form of 16 and its multiple. Pictographic script, Boustrophedon script was found. It was deciphered by I. Mahadevan. Remember this theme. Pictographic script and Boustrophedon script was deciphered by I. Mahadevan. There was equal status for men and women was there. Economic inequality was present and society was not egalitarian. Men and women had equal status, but the society was divided on economic ground. In case of textile, spinning and weaving was found, and three types of burials were found. Burial was there, cremation was there, and post-cremation was there. Though burial was the most common aspect of post-mortal. Majority of people belong to Proto-Australite and Mediterranean tribe. Remember again, majority of people belong to Proto-Australite and Mediterranean, that is Dravidian, though Mongoloid, Nordics were present in the city culture. Then, what about the theories of decline of Indus Valley civilization? Several theories were there, and what is the exact reason is still unknown, but here we will try to understand various names. As per the recent study conducted by Survey of IIT Kharagpur and Archaeological Survey of India, a weaker monsoon, that is drought, could be one of the reasons behind decline of Indus Valley civilization. Then there was a forest service theory. It said environmental changes, which were coupled with the loss of power of rulers, that is central administration of Indus Valley, to sustain the city, had led to decline of the Indus Valley civilization. Also, there might be a resource crunch, resource shortage to sustain the population, and the people moved toward South India. Dravidian people moved toward South India. Another theory by Dr. Gwen Robin Sook, what it says that interpersonal violence, infectious diseases and climate change had played a major role in the demise of Indus Valley civilization. Mortimer Wheeler theory, it talked about Aryan invasion. Robert Reich's theory talked about tectonic movement, floods, and Lumbrick theory talked about changes of course of rivers Indus. So, thank you very much. We will be coming with all these kinds of daily brain teaser that will help you to score maximum marks in UPSC prelims. So, welcome you all to the section of this particular brain teaser of UPSC prelims 2021. Thank you very much. Have a good day. Thank you.